this is the back of the unpowered sites at the Richmond Caravan Park, and they've even got a little cricket pitch here, kids' cricket pitch. All the fun people relaxing. What's that, a house, a private house here? I think there's a private house there. Yeah. Very nice little spot. The wind stayed away. Yeah, serious gardens here with the permanents. This is in one of the back streets of Richmond. We're looking for a parking place. Some of the historic homes are covered in PV cells now. That's the vineyard up there behind that I photographed from the caravan park. Here's our famous, much loved pepper tree, and this is called a picket fence in Percy Street. That's Hollyhock Cottage, and the other one was Banksia Rose. A motorbike, Honda Goldwing from Queensland. And the guy is posing in front of this lovely little church here. Which is now an antique shop. It's a church there. And two guys on the Goldwing and the BMW, they're warming themselves in the sun after riding across Tasmania. It was like Billy Connolly riding by. So now we're entitled to park in the pharmacy car park.
Camberton's lovely too, yeah. It's just inland a bit.
Yeah,
mum
and dad.
And also,
yeah. Lovely rolling pin. Are they, what are they made out of?
Wood.
Yeah, human.
Well, that's the process. Some of them are human parts.
How are we going, guys?
Hey.
There's like the woodworks going. Just wondering whether they outsourced some of these to China. $195 for the clock.
So we just had our coffee with 100 other people in there. Ashmore's full up. Well, there's a wide choice of antique shops and coffee shops. Antique shops and me. $10 each. I'll have to clean mine up. There's the remains of a butter churn, other stuff that nobody wants. So we're going to follow around down this way, and a number of the buildings here, coloured in yellow, are still there. There's not many spots left. We've got photos on the back. The builder saw Cockington Green and thought there wasn't one for an Australian village, so came back and built this one. So the story goes. These are the bonsai trees. And we can probably read all about it on the signs as well. Private Secretary's Cottage, the site of the present museum, and it's still.
So Davy Street.
1991 it was open. A race of people lived here. And this is Davis Street. The convicts filled in part of the bay. You know, there's Lady Nelson.
underwater here. Yeah,
drunken admiral sort of in that area.
No, it's behind us. If this is Davies.
That's about where the drunken admiral is down there. Now the Doon was full of whales in Ralph's Bay. Within 2 years they started whaling. Here's where the drunken admiral spot is now.
So I don't know where that tire is. Might have to go back.
Oh, it's a beautiful day to be a convict. Bit of humour, like in Cockington Green. There's the GPO. Bit of work in the bonsais. It's good enough to dry your washing today. It's a fascinating bit of history, actually. Collins Street.
Didn't know.
She's got her
washing out as well.
Copper.
Yeah. Oil convicts everywhere. The current hospital is on the same site.
Yeah.
That's the rivulet there. I suppose it's flowing in the right direction. Out right to left.
Oh, yeah, it's down through there.
Some of these spots we drove around the other day. So, she was an enterprising lass. Down Elizabeth Street, Hobart Rivulet, runs beneath the mall and under Wellington Bridge, which can still be seen. There's big shadows. A beautiful day. It's the old early corn mill. And that's what I did once. I fell straight down. Now we go down this street, do we?
No, this is Macquarie Street.
Yeah, we've seen it all for your enjoyment, folks. Good display here on the wall of the development of it, laying out all the grass, building all the houses, the first one, and then opening in 1990 or so. And there's the visitor. Fantastic endeavour. Non-photographic trip in here now. We can Google that and there's a virtual tour. That Oriental gentleman was photographing himself in here. It's a very photographic shop. It's all new stuff. This is where we met Trish and the girls and Jillian and the kids when we arrived by plane or something, or car, I can't remember now, but we met in this laneway and they rushed up and the dog
And Tish was waiting in here with Madeline and Ella and Jill. Yeah, I just got a shot without any Chinese in it. I just walked away. Bridge is suffering from a lot of trucks going and a lot of coaches carrying a lot of tourists. Turned off the road in Colebrook. There's a train going past on the side road. That's probably the old station. Oatlands, and there's a roadside stop, and just check it out.
No better than the bank, how they should be run.
Oh my God.
And then there's over here, there's the overflow, so we can get a nice view next to the
right.
The we'll listen. View.
They're up. What's it called now? Like Alverton or something, I think. And there's a RSL back there with schnitzel dinner. Yeah, what a great spot to camp. That's better than Lake Rose and Lake George, isn't it? Why would you camp up there? That's the windmill up there. I'm not sure what the windmill is yet. What a fantastic spot. You got showers nearby, you can SMS and get a code back. The showers, a couple of dollars. Walk up to the RSL for dinner. Fantastic scenery. It could be free. Stay three nights if you like. Beautiful pine trees. Our last night in Tasmania. Excellent. You may not even need the heater. There's some caves over there. A couple of people camping nearby with a fire. And the overflow is up across the road in a park, in a less exciting spot.
See it on Flickr, of course.